It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me, and I'm feeling good. I'm feeling good.
I go far out in the sun. Now what I mean.
Are you the man they call Angel? You're late. I'm sorry. It was not easy for me to come here. My wife Mary and I are in grave danger and seek your services to help us. Mary's so frightened and
look, I'm here for the money, not the soul story. What's the deal?
A game. I'm sorry. We're headed for Bethlehem and must make it in time for the census. Mary's very pregnant and we're being pursued by Herod. I feel I'm being watched. That man over there, for instance, he's far too curious for my liking.
He's probably wondering what a guy like you is doing in a bar like this. Look, with a lunatic like Herod after you, you're gonna have to stay under radar. You better be prepared to pay some big cash. Protecting you won't be cheap.
Mr. Angel, we are people, not cattle. If you truly care about life...
Life? Who cares about life? Life certainly never cared about me.
Well, you do come highly recommended. If money is all you care about, then you shall be well paid.
Well then, if you'll excuse me, there's just someone I have to see. Godfather, a man named Joseph is here. He's running from Herod and seeks my protection. I'm thinking of taking the job. What?
Some people.
Godfather, I can't understand what you're saying. Godfather, just... Not if you think I should take the job.
Who was that?
That's my godfather. He likes to keep an eye on me. It's all sorted. I'll see you in the morning.
But how?
Will I find you? Shouldn't be a problem. Play it again, Sam.
Sam, my name's David.
Joseph, don't lag behind.
Come on, Mary, we'll do as he says.
I don't know, Joseph. Can we trust him?
We're here, and now we wait.
Wait? What are we waiting for?
Not what. Who?
Who? Then who are we waiting for?
An associate of mine, whom I've worked with often. An expert in disguises. Well, less of an expert and more of an enthusiast. There she is.
Where?
Over there.
What? Behind that person with the beard?
No, she is the person with the beard. Never mind.
Thomas Angel, me old mate, how are you?
You're late.
Late? I'm here, ain't I? Besides, you're early.
You were supposed to be here 10 minutes ago.
10 minutes? It's a bleeding desert. Don't mind him, he's always a bit moody. How do you do? I'm MacGyver. Susie MacGyver. Mac for short.
I'm Joseph. Your disguise is incredible. How do you do it?
What? This whole thing? Well, some say it's a gift. And you are?
Hi, I'm Mary. We've hired Mr. Angel here to take us to Bethlehem.
Bethlehem? What's happening there?
A census. We must register. But we're afraid. We're being pursued by Herod.
You're in Herod's bad books, eh?
Let's get going. We can't hang around here all day.
Why even go bother to register at all?
Because an angel of the Lord appeared to us and told us to go there.
Angel, isn't that funny? An angel told them to go, so they hired you to take them.
This guy's hardly an angel.
Now listen, I know he might not have all the wings and the halo and stuff, but this guy is the business. One time, he jumped 2 stories onto a horse just to make a fast getaway. And another time...
We've got to go. And stop telling him stories like that. They're not even true.
That's because if I told you guys the truth, you wouldn't even believe it. So one time, he took on 100 armed men with a milk bottle and a toothpick. Carnage!
Come on!
He's right. Bethlehem won't walk to itself, you know.
The sun went down and the jungle fire was burning. Down the track came a hobo hiking, and he said, "Boys, I'm not turning. I'm headed for a land that's far away, beside the crystal fountain. So come with me, we'll go and see the Rock Candy Mountains. In the big Rock Candy Mountains, all the cops have wooden legs, and the bulldogs all have rubber teeth, and the hens lay soft-boiled eggs. The farmer's trees are full of fruit, and the barns are full of hay. Oh, I'm bound to go where there ain't no snow, where the rain don't fall, the wind don't blow, in the big Rock Candy Mountains."
Donkey, that'll do.
We'd better set up camp. It's getting late.
And in the morning, I'm making waffles. So who's this we're protecting?
Some sort of king or something. Not sure. I've protected kings before, and they're always full of their own self-importance. They seem to think the census is just a way for a hero to lure them out into an easy place to kill them. I don't know. All care. They're paying, and that's all that matters. Angel?
Well, yes I am. We mostly come at night. Mostly.
Whoa!
Am I dead? Should I be walking towards the light?
No, you're very much alive, Thomas. You do not walk alone in your protection of Mary. God is walking with you. Look, the Virgin will conceive a child. She'll give birth to a son, and he'll be called Emmanuel, meaning God is with us.
Who is this child?
Oh, Bethlehem of Judah. You are not just a lowly village in Judah, for a ruler will come from you who will be the shepherd for my people Israel.
I don't understand.
You will. God loves you, Thomas.
How could he love me? After everything I've done?
For God so loves the world that he will send his only son, that for whoever believes in him will not perish but have eternal life.
Wait. Didn't you say you were looking for Joseph?
Oh yeah. I was about to warn Joseph that Mary has been kidnapped by Herod's men.
I know Kung Fu.
Maximus, and I have captured your pregnant wench.
Give her back to me.
Of course not. What are you, mad? Why won't I give her back just like that?
Because I asked for it. Well, never mind. If you will not give her, perhaps we play again.
Well, why would I do that? You're obviously much stronger than I. I am an academic man. I'm not stooped to your levels of violence.
Well, since you claim to be an academic man, I challenge you to a battle of wits.
For her? To the death? I accept.
Very well. The Battle of Wits has begun. One of these plates of sushi has a whole lot of wasabi sauce on it. The battle ends when you decide. Then we see who gets the girl and who gets the nosebleed.
But it's so easy. All I have to do is divine from what I know of you. Now, are you the sort of man that would put the wasabi in his own sushi or his enemies? Now, a clever man would put the wasabi in his own sushi because he knows that only a great fool would reach for what he's been given. And I am not a great fool, so I can clearly not choose the sushi in front of you. But you would have known that. You would have counted on it. So I can clearly not choose the sushi in front of me.
So you've made your decision then?
Not remotely, because something as evil as wasabi comes from Samaria, which everyone knows is entirely peopled by criminals. And criminals are used to having people not trust them, as I am not trusted by you. So I can clearly not choose the sushi in front of you.
Truly, your intellect is dizzying.
Wait till I get going! Now, where was I?
Samaria.
Ah, yes, Samaria. You had suspected I knew wasabi's origin, so I can clearly not choose the sushi in front of me.
You're just stalling now.
Ah, you'd like to think that, wouldn't you? You've been in my ninjas, which tells me you're very strong. So you could have put the wasabi in your own sushi, trusting on your strength to save you. But you've also bested them using funky kung fu skills, which means that you must have studied. And in studying, you would have learned that man is mortal. So you would put the wasabi as far away from you as possible. So I can clearly not choose the sushi in front of me.
You're trying to make me give something away. It won't work.
But it has worked. You've given everything away. I know where the wasabi is.
Then you've got to ask yourself one question. Do I feel lucky? Well, do you, punk?
Yes, and I choose. What on earth could that be?
What? Where? I don't see anything. All I see is a group of people watching a show.
Sworn I could have seen something. Anyway, let's see. You from yours, me from mine.
You chose wrong. You chose wrong? You chose wrong.
Inconceivable! You did not choose wrong. I switched sushis when your back was turned! You fell for one of the classic blunders! The first being never get involved in a committee in a Presbyterian church. Are they slightly less well known as this? Never go up against Spartacus Julius Claudius where the nosebleed is on the line! I'm a nose!
Mary, are you hurt?
Shaken, but not stirred. What do you think? That whole time, it was your sushi that was wasabi'd.
Actually, they were both wasabi'd. I spent a year running a sushi bar and built up an immunity to it.
I'm gonna be, I'm gonna be. man who goes along with you. When I'm lonely, well, I know I'm going to be. I'm going to be the man who's lonely when I'm two. And when I'm dreaming, well, I know I'm going to dream. I'm going to dream about the kind of when I'm with you. But
Mary?
Surely you can't be serious.
I am serious. Don't call me Shirley.
Joseph, we need to hurry.
Quick, let's try this place.
Old crone, we need a room. Have you got anything? Anything at all?
Do you like cats?
I beg your pardon?
Do you like cats? I'm afraid we're rather full on account of a large booking by the Bethlehem chapter of the Cats Protection League. They're doing a seminar on neutering. Let me see. We do have a small...
Oh, we'll take it. We'll take it. How much?
Well, it is census season, so you're going to have to pay. Why don't you just give me the bag, eh? There you go.
Joseph. Did you see that? She just shortchanged you. Yeah, let me get you the right money. You dirty rat! Show me the money!
No, Thomas, we don't have time. Anyway, she smells like she needs the money more than we do.
Here you go.
Joseph, it's happening.
What? I don't know anything about birthing babies.
Don't freak out. Just don't freak out.
Just use the force, Joseph. Use the force. Matt, help me out.
Mary, a new life. This is going to be so beautiful.
No.
Some say love, she is a river that drowns the tender beast. Some say
this. Hey,
nobody puts baby in the corner.
Hey, this is it. It's like so cool. Oh my gosh.
And you are...
Bethany. Crystal.
Kendall.
Tiffany.
No, I didn't mean personal introductions. Who are you and what are you doing here?
Well, we're shepherds. But not really shepherds, but actually trained performers.
Thespians, dancers,
singers, and entertainers.
No singing!
You guys are awesome.
No singing. Well, it was nice to meet you, but we're really busy, so...
But we haven't even seen the baby!
We have to see it, sing to it, dance for it!
Stop it! What are you talking about?
Okay, Crystal, you're the best at telling this. Stage is yours.
Thank you, Brittany. Now, would you like it in a song?
Yeah!
No! Oh, no? Oh, okay. Perhaps an interpretive dance?
Yes.
No! Oh. Just tell us what you're doing here.
Okay, well, we girls have been training for so long to be actors and performers. We've graduated from the best schools in Judea.
But, you know, the money isn't so good for people in our line of work, unless you make the big time. So while we're waiting for that big break, we took up some work to supplement our income. Waitressing has so been done before.
So we took up shepherding. And who knew it could be so fun?
I know! All that time to sing under the stars.
Stop that! Well, it's a lovely story, but now you really have to go.
We all have minding our own business.
Practicing our latest dance routine, would you like to see it?
No!
Yes!
When this massive choir of angels, like, erupted from the sky, telling us that a new king had been born, and that we had to follow the star where he was. And the funniest thing was that we were looking for a star, you know, like Keanu Reeves.
Or Tyra Banks.
Or Christian Bale. But in actual fact, it was a star, like, in the sky. And here we are.
And what did the angel tell you to do when you found the king?
To dance for the new king!
You're not the fortune.
None of this makes any sense. Who are these people? Who is this baby?
That was awesome. Angel, are you okay?
None of this makes any sense.
Some work, and we can't get employed if you're sitting around here drunk all the time.
Get lost then. No one's asking me to stay. Anyway, I'm tired of working. All our jobs just end up the same.
Look, Mama always said that life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're gonna get. You can't keep hiding around here in this bar. You need to get some rest. Come on, let's go.
Stop acting like you're my best friend. You're as bad as that Mary and Joseph cup.
Everyone is always telling me how moody you are. I just tell them how cool you are. I'm starting to think that they're right and I'm wrong after all.
Whatever. Barman, give me another drink.
I mean, haven't you been wondering about that job that we did? Why do you think that they hired you to protect them? What if Mary, or Joseph, or that kid? What if that kid is someone special?
Look, I don't care about them, or the kid. They hired me to look after them. I did that. They paid, and that's the end of it, as far as I'm concerned.
But didn't you hear Mary singing at the campsite that night? You can't tell me that you aren't moved by that.
Where's that drink?
And that angel showing up with that warning that Mary was getting kidnapped. I mean, you have to ask yourself, why does Harry want to get his hands on her? I mean, you can't deny that something's going on here.
Herod's got his reasons, and that don't concern you or me.
Come to think of it, those shepherds, it's like they knew where to come to find us and the baby.
You don't honestly believe all that stuff, do you?
Maybe I do. If it's a choice between believing them or sitting here with you, well, then I'm out of here.
Why don't you just go then?
Presenting your Royal Highness, the illustrious, the amazing, the all-seeing, the all-powerful, the all-knowing Herod, self-proclaimed ruler of the world, etc., etc., etc.
I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. You like to move it.
Maurice, all this singing and glowing has made me rather thirsty, and we are in a bar. Would you give me one of those little traffic lights that look so pretty?
Yes, Your Royal Highness, then maybe we should get down to business.
Maurice, let us get down to business. What is our business?
The baby king.
Ah, yes, this baby king. If he is a king, then where is his crown? What kind of king doesn't have a crown? I've got a crown, but a very nice one. Here it is on my head. Maurice, have I got it on?
Yes, Your Magnificent.
Ah, good. Then what time is it? I say it's time to robot. I am a very clever king. I am super genius. I am robot king of the Jews. And I had my very profound brain thinkings in my head. I decided to hire you to track down the wise men and find this baby king. And to make you feel good, I'm going to give you lots and lots of money.
Really?
No, not really. But we hear you are the best in the business.
and that you've even scared away the dreaded Fusa.
So I've devised a devious and cunning plan which involves you finding this baby King Jesus.
No, I can't do it. I won't do it.
Oh, shut up, you naughty little angel. You're so annoying. What are you, a pansy?
I'm no pansy. I just feel I've been in this game for far too long. Anyway, I don't see why you have a problem with this baby everyone's talking about. It's just a baby.
Oh, silence, you bozo! How dare you question my exceedingly devious plan? Maybe, Maurice, we should take him and show him the bottom of our shark tank. Do we still have those sharks with the laser beams attached to their heads? Maybe give him the heebie-jeebies and persuade him to cooperate.
It's gonna take more than empty threats to change my mind.
Well, then perhaps a darn good thrashing would change your mind. Maurice, I am tired. Lift up my arm and give him a thrashing.
Stop that! Stop it! It's annoying! Look, if it means that much to you, it means you'll stop annoying me. I'll make this my last job. Just show me the money.
Good. And just to show you our gratitude, I'm prepared to overlook your questioning of my inspired wisdom. What is a simple bite on the buttocks between friends? No more Fusa, and soon no more baby king. Anyway, I have much other important things to do. See you later, crocodile.
I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. You like to move it.
Doesn't make any sense. Who are these people? They seem like regular people. But why do I hear everyone talking about this baby being a king? It just doesn't make any sense.
Let us halt to get refreshments. It is scorching and I am parched. Anyone for a flagon of meat?
Yeah, bro.
My good magi companions, we must pause only momentarily. These are treacherous roads, and we are almost at our destination.
The star is upon us.
You have indeed spoken correctly, my learned friend.
It's learned, Pepe. Learned. Could you just please tell me more about the star that we've been following? All you've said so far is that we're on an endeavor to receive the Messiah. Whatever that means, could you please just tell me in a language I actually understand?
These events were foretold centuries earlier by the prophets of Israel. The prophet Isaiah said, "The Lord himself will give a sign. A virgin will be with child. She will give birth to a baby son and will call him Emmanuel." So the Jewish nation has known that a Messiah, an anointed one, is coming. After centuries in exile and under the rule of foreign kingdoms and empires, many are now hopeful. They just don't know when the Messiah will come or what he will be like. That time is here. The Virgin has given birth. He is here. That is why I've been following the star.
Following a thesaurus, more like it.
Don't be alarmed. I come in peace.
Thomas, what are you doing here?
Seems I don't need to ask you the same question, Matt. Hey, your disguises are getting pretty good.
No, they aren't disguises. I'm working for them. I wanted to help them. They have gifts for Joseph and for Mary's boy Jesus. But it seems that you have answered my question. What are you doing here? The last time I saw you, you were drowning your sorrows in some pub.
Yes, sorry for the way I carried on. I was angry and confused. Very confused. Mick, Herod's hired me to find out the traitor guys and find where Jesus is and relay that to him.
What the heck, are you crazy? You know that Herod wants to kill Jesus. What are you thinking?
Not my proudest moment, I know. But I also know I've made the wrong choice. I've been following you guys for ages and doing a lot of thinking. And I'm finally ready to make the right choice. I want to help you. I want to help Mary and Joseph. They have to save Jesus.
But Herod must be paying you an immense deal of capital. And by turning, you will not merely be forfeiting your money, but perhaps even your life.
Frankly, Magi, I don't give a damn. After all, tomorrow is another day. And it's just a risk I'm willing to take. I was listening to your conversation earlier, and it finally makes sense. I now know who this baby is, and what I must do. We have to go.
sun went down and the jungle fire was burning. Down the track came a hobo hiking, and he said, boys, I'm not turning. I'm headed for a land that's far away, beside the crystal fountains. So come with me, we'll go and see the big rock candy mountains. In the big rock candy mountains, all the cops have wooden legs, and the bulldogs all have rubber teeth, and the hens lay soft-boiled eggs. The farmer's trees are full of fruit, and the barns are full of hay. Oh, I'm bound to go where there ain't no snow, where the rain don't fall, the wind don't blow, in the big rock candy mountains.